What is up, everybody, and welcome to another commentary. So first of all, I want to say that the gameplay you're seeing in the background is some Call of Duty Black Ops 2 from the PC and some Call of Duty Black Ops 3 from the PS4. I haven't really recorded anything from the PC version of Black Ops 3, so I hope you can live with that. So a lot of things have happened this week in the Call of Duty world with the reveal of Black Ops 4, but I won't go over too much detail about that because I think you have seen that from a lot of other YouTubers. They have talked about the new stuff that is in this game and how the game has been changed and stuff like that. So I want to give you my impressions about the game so far based on the trailers and all the gameplay that these Code VIPs have showed so far. But I will go over it quickly, what we have learned about the game so far. So to quickly go over what we saw, Matt Harris wasn't lying with all the stuff he had leaked earlier. It was all only some of that was live, but this is a multiplayer game only with the standard multiplayer, but newly redesigned, or what you can call it. So it's more in style with Overwatch or Rainbow Six Siege with the classes and stuff like that. Then we get zombies and we get a battle royale mode. So the first trailer they released really split up the community with a lot of players that didn't like what they saw, and I kind of agree with that, because when I first saw the trailer, I was kind of no, this is not something for me, because it really looked like another futuristic shooter, and it is futuristic, but it's not up there with Black Ops 4. It's more in between Black Ops 3. It's more in between Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 3, so in 2040 or something like that. So it's not completely in the future, but it's still a near future, and I think a lot of us have hoped that we will see a modern day shooter from Treyarch, but that didn't happen. So after that, I have seen, like I said before, a lot of gameplay from the COD VIPs, and I was disappointed at first, but then I saw all the gameplays, and this Call of Duty might not look that bad. And one of the things that really caught my attention was not a trailer for the PC, I would call, but they really talked about how they are building a PC version that is the PC worthy. Now, if you haven't played Call of Duty on PC, I think since the release of Modern Warfare 2 or something, the PC ports has always been very, very poor. I mean, you can of course play it, but they have been badly optimized. There is really no kind of anti-cheat. I think there is, but it's really, really bad. And the player base on the PC is very, very small. I think the average player in Call of Duty World War 2 is about 5,000 to 6,000, and it peaks with about 9,000 to 10,000. So it's very low compared to what they have on console. And I get why people on PC don't want to play it, because I have been playing a lot of World War 2 on the PC lately, and every other game I ran into a cheater, it's very, very obvious. So they have really, really not been doing very well with the PC, and I don't really understand why, because the PC as a gaming platform has really, really grown over the past years. I remember in 2012 where I saw a video from Level Cap talking about that the PC platform for gaming is dying, and a lot of people were talking about that the PC platform for gaming was dying, but he kind of proved them wrong and showed that it is actually growing, and it has just grown a lot. And I think a lot of this has to do with the esports. Pretty much most of the games that is played in esports and played on PC, at least the FPS shooters, are played on PC, and that is only Call of Duty, I think, that is played on console. I know that Rainbow Six Siege also has some competitive on the Xbox One, but I think that got dropped later, so it's only on PC now. So the PC is not completely dead. It is growing a lot, and I think it's growing very, very fast. And I think we can thank games like League of Legends, Dota 2 for this, because back in the day, PC players always complained about that the console was holding it back, and that was true, of course, but I think that has actually helped the PC to grow a lot, because nowadays you don't need a beast of a PC to play the most popular games. I know, of course, PUBG requires a pretty good PC, but Fortnite, CSGO, League of Legends, Legends, Dota 2 doesn't really need you to have a beast of a PC to play them. And I think that has actually helped PC platform, because now you can get everybody to play on the PC, or a lot of more people can buy a cheap PC and play these newer games. But that has been a big problem for Call of Duty, because they have been so poorly optimized. People have just left the platform because they couldn't run it very well. And I mean, I don't have the super best PC, but I have a good PC, and I have problems running the newer Call of Duties on it because they run so poorly, are so poorly optimized. I think this was very, very, very good news. I think it's about time that they realized that the PC is a great platform to deliver games. I really, really hope that they are coming through with this and make a PC version and support the PC version like we deserve. So that was a little bit step upwards with the Call of Duty World War II, but not enough to bring the players back on the PC to Call of Duty on the PC. And I think they have to do a lot more with this, a lot more, and I hope they will do that with Black Ops 4, because I didn't think they really realized that on PC there is a lot of, you can call it, competition compared to consoles. There is a lot of free games that is almost as good as some of the AAA titles, so you cannot just make a PC version and then, well, here, buy this, and then it runs like a shade. So you have to do something with it, and I really hope they do this time with the PC version of Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Another thing I noticed was in this trailer for the PC version, they showed some kind of clips for esports, and that made me believe that maybe we are going to see Call of Duty esports or competitive on both PC and on PS4, of course. And I think this would really, really help the PC version grow, because nowadays a lot of players like a game is of course easy to go into, but you have to play a lot to master it, and that shows in games like Fortnite, PUBG, Overwatch, Rainbow Six Siege, and stuff like that. It's games that is quite easy to, I would say, learn or play, but it is very, very hard to master. And before, back in the day, I think that Activision and the Call of Duty teams developed Call of Duty to be easy as possible, so everybody could play it, and that was the times back then. But nowadays, people want some challenge, and so if it has to succeed on the PC, I think it will be great idea to release competitive on PC and have a game that is pretty easy to learn but hard to master. And the way they have built up the multiplayer this time, I think they might be want to be doing that. And I have a little bit of idea that this game is maybe the game we are going to see in the competitive scene for the next three years or something, because Trey talked about they will support this for the next 4 years. So maybe this is the game we are going to see. And I think this is a great idea too, because the numbers of people watching competitive Call of Duty is actually dropping, and I think it has something to do with them releasing a new game every year. But I want to make a separate video on that, because there's a lot of talk about that. Another thing I noticed, or I've seen some rumors about, is that the DLC maps is going to be free this year, and that is another great idea, because that is really something that have bothered me and a lot of other players a lot, that you have to pay for these new maps, and not a lot of people want to pay for these new maps nowadays. The DLC model is too outdated, and they have to give people the map for free, and then they must earn their money otherwise. You splitting the player base a lot by doing that, so I think this would be a very good idea, so I hope they do that. So overall, I think that Black Ops 4 is looking very, very good after seeing a lot of the gameplays that the COD VIPs have showed us. So I'm really hyped for this game, and I cannot wait to play the private beta that is coming here. I think it's going to be in the summer, July or August, so we will see. But anyways, that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please give a like and subscribe, and have a nice day. Bye.